To advance the country's life-saving biomedical research and discoveries, the federal government, after World War II, decided to partner with academic institutions, like UC San Francisco. Central to this partnership is federal funding for research. This funding comes in two forms. The first is called direct funding. Direct funding pays the salaries of scientists, students, and other research personnel for supplies and equipment, and for the travel costs associated with conducting and sharing research. UCSF is the top public recipient of funding from the National Institutes of Health and received $465 million in direct funding from the NIH in 2016. But scientists need other support to conduct their work, which is where the second type of funding comes in. The federal government also reimburses academic research institutions for the facilities and administrative costs associated with their research. These funds are sometimes called FNA or indirects. This funding helps pay for costs of buildings, both new and old, especially designed for research, maintenance and security for all of our research spaces, benches, desks, and computers, electricity, water, air conditioning, and heating for research spaces, IT to support and meet computing needs, and staff to ensure compliance with the government's environmental health and safety regulations that protect our researchers, staff, students, and patients. These FNA costs are an essential part of the price of doing research and totaled $253 million in 2016 for UCSF. But the federal government covers all these costs, right? Wrong. In 2016, the government reimbursed UCSF just $160 million, or 63% of total FNA costs associated with federal research. UCSF made up the difference, paying $93 million to cover the remaining costs. This means that for every $1,000 in federal research funding that went to UCSF researchers in 2016, the university had to raise another $183 to keep the lights on and maintain all the infrastructure essential to our research. Why? Unlike other federal contractors, universities are limited from claiming the full cost of overhead expenses necessary to their research. This is due in part to an exacting negotiation process with the government that requires research institutions to identify and defend costs associated with federally sponsored research eligible for reimbursement. Existing government-imposed reimbursement caps on certain types of research grants and on administrative costs further erode universities' reimbursement rates. And although the FNA cost reimbursement process isn't perfect, the decades-long partnership between research universities and the federal government is key to our country's success in advancing biomedical research, leading to life-saving treatments and improved health outcomes for patients. Despite the long-standing success of this partnership, some in Washington want to significantly reduce the federal government's role in funding FNA. Efforts to reduce or cap FNA cost reimbursement would hurt UCSF faculty and trainees and harm our ability to advance important discoveries. Cuts to federal FNA funding would impact our ability to maintain large, specialized equipment that is shared among researchers, provide the administrators who ensure all safety for faculty, trainees, staff, and patients, purchase and maintain IT for our computing needs, take care of and maintain existing research space and buildings, including janitorial services and security services, and plan for and construct new buildings with the cutting-edge facilities needed for the latest research. The bottom line is that any proposal to reduce the federal government's contributions to FNA will hurt UCSF's ability to advance our critical mission of biomedical research.